Hi students, this is Srinivas, Department of Botany. This video was shooted by cell phone camera. So I request you use earphones to watch this. Thank you. I am going to explain about chapter 2, sexual reproduction in flowering plants. This is the chapter 2 and it requires 17 periods. This is the period 1. What are flowering plants? The plants that produce flowers are called flowering plants. That means we have to know the plant kingdom classification or Plantae. This is the plant kingdom classification or Plantae. So plants are divided into two groups, cryptogams, phanerogams. What are cryptogams? Cryptogams are non-flowering plants or flowerless plants, whereas phanerogams are flowering plants. So that means cryptogams are flowerless plants or non-flowering plants, phanerogams are flowering plants. These cryptogams are divided into three groups, algae, bryophyta, pteridophyta. All these three groups are flowerless only. Phanerogams, it contains only one group, that is spermatophyta. Spermato means seeds. Phyta means plants. The plants that produce seeds are called spermatophyta. It contains two groups, gymnosperms and another one is angiosperms. Here gymno means naked. Naked seeds are present. Angio means enclosed. So that is enclosed seeds are present in angiosperms. Here this angiosperms contain two groups. One is called dicots. Other one is monocots. What is dicot? Means a seed with two cotyledons. Di means two. Mono means one. So that means a seed with two cotyledons is called dicot or dicotyledonous seed. A seed with one cotyledon is called monocotyledon seed. So here this is angiosperm. That means flowering plants. This is the flowering plants. So flowering plants means here these angiosperms. In this chapter we discuss about angiosperms. Flowering plants means angiosperms here. Sexual reproduction in flowering plants. So that is, plants will produce flowers. Okay. For what purpose they produce flowers? They produce flowers of their own, or the plants will produce flowers for us? Not for us. They produce of their own, that is by the plants. The plants produce flowers. These flowers may be of different types. Some flowers may produce good smell, that is good scented flowers, good perfumes. Some flowers may give bad odor also. So like that, plants will produce different types of flowers, different colors also. So plants are categorized into different types. Some are ornamental plants. What are ornamental plants? That means which are used for decoration purpose are called ornamental plants. Study of ornamental plants is called horticulture. What are the different types of ornamental plants? That is rose, tulip, hibiscus, chrysanthemum, marigold, etc. In our syllabus, in taxonomy, that is in families, there are few ornamental plants listed in the syllabus, NCERT syllabus. What are they? The Fabaceae ornamental plants are lupine or lupinus. Another one is sweet pea. Scientific name is Lathyrus odoratus. The Fabaceae ornamental plants means these two. Like that, the Solanaceae ornamental plant is petunia. The liliaceae ornamental plants are gloriosa. Other one is tulip. What is the importance of this tulip means? If the flowers are infected means generally no economical value. But the flower, tulip flowers means if the tulip flowers are more infected by virus means the more is the economical value. This is very very important point. Tulip flowers are infected with virus means those flowers have high economical and commercial value. Some flowers are used in social and cultural celebrations also. That means sunflower, rose, lily, jasmine, lotus, etc. So these are the different types of ornamental plants and these are the flowers used in social and cultural celebrations. What are the parts of a flower? What is a flower? Those points we have to discuss. What is a flower? Flower is a modified shoot useful for sexual reproduction. So how does that flower is developed? That is, flower is developed from floral primordium. From floral primordium, flower is developed. This is very, very important. Flower is developed from floral primordium. Primordium means that group of initial cells. Floral means flower. So the group of initial cells that gives rise to flower, that part is so called floral primordium. What are the parts of a flower? Parts of a flower. There are four different parts of a flower. Four parts. That is sepals, petals, stamens, carpels. Sepals are also called calyx, petals also called corolla, stamens also called andricium, carpels also called gynecium. So that is calyx, the individual members, the individual units in calyx are called sepals, the individual units in corolla are called petals, the individual units in andricium are called stamens, the individual units in gynecium are called carpels. So that means how these may be considered as floral leaves. How many kinds of floral leaves? Four kinds. As we are saying, these are floral leaves. These are developed from nodes. What is a node? The part of the stem where the leaf arises is called a node. We are considering these as floral leaves means each one is arising from each node. That means how many nodes are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. That means a typical flower contains 4 nodes. If nodes 4 means number of internodes means 3. How does that internodes will come means number of nodes minus 1. Number of internodes is equal to number of nodes minus 1. So that means typical flower contains number of nodes 4, number of internodes 3. So these are the parts of a flower. So that means we have to know the symbols also. That is, symbol of calyx is K, symbol of corolla is C, symbol of andricium is A, symbol of gynecium is G. So typical flower contains all those four parts. So this is the floral diagram. This is the LS of a flower. LS means longitudinal section. LS means longitudinal section of a flower. So this part is called sepals. This part is called petals and stamen. Stamen contains two parts, the long stalk-like structure called filament. At the tip of the filament, this structure is called anther. These two parts together called stamen. And this is called the gynecium. The gynecium contains how many parts? Means three parts. The basal swollen part is called, ovary. And the tip of the ovary, long stalk called style. At the tip of the style, stigma is present. The part present between ovary and stigma is style. What is the function of stigma? This stigma will receive the pollen grains. Pollen grain receptivity part is stigma. Where do you find the ovules? See, in this diagram, these are the ovules. Ovules are born, ovules are arise inside the ovary. So ovules are born in ovary. After fertilization, ovary will develop into fruits and ovules will develop into seeds. So this is a flower. Study of flower is called study of flower yielding plants is called floriculture. Study of flower yielding plants is called floriculture. Flori means flower. Like that, some plants will produce timber. That means timber yielding plants. Study of timber yielding plants is called silviculture. So sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction. What is the other name of sexual reproduction? Sexual reproduction is also called amphimixis. Amphi means both. That means both male and female gametes. Mixis means get together. So that is fusing of both male and female gametes occur. That's why sexual reproduction other name is amphimixis. The sexual reproduction in plants was discovered by Camerarius. Sexual reproduction in plants discovered by Camerarius. And here the male and female sex organs, the male reproductive part of a flower is andrisium or stamens, the female reproductive part of a flower is gynecium or carpels. Sexual reproduction means the reproductive parts, the andrisium will produce male gametes and the gynecium will produce female gametes, so that male and female gametes are fused together. So fusion of male and female gametes, this is so called sexual reproduction. As the two gametes are mixing together, this is so called amphimixis. The sexual reproduction plants discovered by Camerarius. Here embryology also we have to learn, that is development of male and female gametes, fertilization, embryo. So the study of development of male and female gametes, this is the symbol of male and this is the symbol of female. So the development of male and female gametes, process of fertilization, formation of embryo. All these aspects study under a branch called embryology. Famous embryologist in India, that is Indian embryologist पी महेश्वरी पांचनन महेश्वरी. So andrisium contains the stalk like structure called filament. At the tip of the filament anther is present. Both filament and anther together called stamen.